ज्ञानानन्दरसानुभूति सहित स्मेर प्रसन्नाननम् पूर्णेन्दुप्रभमात्मबोधनिलयम् शान्तम् निरीहम् परम् नित्यानित्यविचारसारचतुरम् निर्मत्सरम् पावनम् श्रीभूमानन्दमहं नतोऽस्मि कलितानन्दम् परम्
दृष्टान्तो नैव दृष्टः त्रिभुवनजठरे सद्गुरोर्ज्ञानदातुः स्पर्शश्चेत्तत्र कल्प्यः स नयति यदहो स्वर्णतामश्मसारम् न स्पर्शत्वं तथापि श्रितचरणयुगे सद्गुरुस्वीयशिष्ये स्वीयं साम्यं विधत्ते भवति निरुपमः तेन वा अलौकिकोऽपि स्वीयं साम्यं विधत्ते भवति निरुपमः तेन वा अलौकिकोऽपी नमो नमस्ते गुरवे महात्मने विमुक्तसङ्गाय सदुत्तमाय नित्याद्वयानन्दरसस्वरूपिणे भूम्ने सदा पारदयाम्बुधाम्ने स्वाराज्यसाम्राज्यविभूतिरेषा भवत्कृपा श्रीमहिमप्रसादात् प्राप्ता मया श्रीगुरवे महात्मने नमो नमस्ते स्तु पुनर्नमो नमो नमस्तेऽस्तु पुनर्नमोऽस्तु नमो नमस्तेऽस्तु पुनर्नमोऽस्तु
हम को मन की शक्ति देना मन विजय करे दूसरों के जैसे पहले खुद को जय करे सके, दूसरों से भूल हो तो माफ कर सके, झूठ से बचे रहे, सच कदम भरे,
at the holy lotus feet of our beloved Guru Pujya Swami Bhumananda Tirtha Ji. Pranams at the lotus feet of Swami Nirvisheshananda Tirtha Ji and pranams to Ma Guru Priya Ji. We offer our namaskarams and pranams to Sri Shashi Shekhar Vempati Ji, Sri Dr. E. Sridharan, and to all of you gathered here today from far and wide for this occasion, which is a very special one for all of us who are associated with our Pujya Swamiji over the last so many years. As you know, today is the book release of a great association, Glimpses into the Life of Swami Bhumananda Tirtha Ji. This book, written by Swami Nirvisheshananda Tirtha Ji, has been many years in coming. In the words of Ma Guru Priya Ji, it is a long-awaited book, something that devotees have been waiting eagerly for, and we ourselves did not know when it would actually happen. Today is the day, and we would like to request Pujya Swamiji and our chief guest, our guest of honor, Nutan Swamiji and Ma Guru Priya Ji, to please take their seats on the stage. As you all know, all our programs start with the lighting of the inaugural lamp by Ma Guru Priya Ji, and we would request Ma now to please light the inaugural lamp.
Yontah pravishya mama vacham imam prasuptam Sanjeevayatyakhila-shakti-dharasvadhamna Anyamshcha-hasta-charana-shravanatvagadin Pranannamo-bhagavate-purushayatubhyam Pranannamo-bhagavate Shayatubhyam.
It is a great honor and privilege to be introducing to all of you Sri Shashi Shekhar Vempati, who is here today with his son Anirudh. We are very happy that Anirudh is also here today. Sri Shashi Shekhar ji is the Chief Executive Officer of Prasara Bharati, which, as you all know, is our main public broadcaster. Doordarshan and All India Radio come under Prasara Bharati. He is an alumni of IIT Mumbai and a techie who was at Infosys for, I think, about 15 years. He is obviously very accomplished because he is the four-time winner of the Infosys Annual Awards for Excellence in Innovation and IP. He obviously has a bent for serving the country, which must have made him leave Bangalore and his comfortable life, move to Delhi, and take up such a challenging role in Prasara Bharati. But it is for his vision of digitizing our public broadcast system to make it connected to the citizens. Our citizens, even in villages and the Doodwala, everyone is connected through internet and their phones nowadays. And I think part of what we understand Shashi Shekhar ji to be doing is to make sure that we are effectively able to reach everyone in this country. This is the layman's understanding of what was written in his bio, because he's very technologically accomplished, but that's not something which the average person like us understands, so we have translated it to you. And if we are wrong, we would request him to correct it. Now I have to introduce somebody who needs no introduction. One of our most honored citizens of our country, Dr. E. Sridharan, Padma Vibhushan, recognized in India and outside India, not only for his professional achievements and role in building the nation, but his integrity. He is renowned for his integrity and his super efficiency. And all of you know that very well. But for those of us in the ashram, Sridharan ji and Radha ji, his wife, who is also present here today, are Pujya Swamiji's disciples and devotees, coming very regularly, keeping in touch with Pujya Swamiji, present for all our ashram programs, mixing with all the devotees in their unassuming way, being one of us. We are very happy that Sridharan ji is able to be here, and Radhaji also agreed to come with him. As you all know, he has a very hectic schedule, going around the country constantly, making sure that the metros in the various states, those projects take off. But recently he had a severe setback in his health, and we were sure that he would not come to Delhi. But providentially, the date changed and Sridharanji's health improved, and we all pleaded with Radhaji that she should definitely accompany him so that we feel comfortable that he will not get into any trouble. She agreed, and she's here today, and all of us are really very happy that he's present. We would now be requesting Sri Shashi Shekhar ji to release the book and present the first copy to Sridharan ji. We would request Sri Shashi ji to address us now on this occasion.
Namaskar, and thank you for having me this evening. Pujya Swami Bhuma Nanda Tirtha ji, Pujya Swami Nirvishesha Nanda Tirtha ji, Ma Guru Priya ji, and Dr. Sridharan ji, and all the distinguished guests. It is my honor and privilege to be present here today. I'm very happy that along with the release of the great association, a minor association on my part has been made as well to become part of this spiritual journey. It's the first time that I've come to know about Swamiji and his work and his life. And I also got an early glimpse of the book. So it also gave me an insight into all the work that you've done. So thank you for this opportunity. As the title says, this book offers a glimpse into the life of Swami Bhumananda Tirthaji. But from what I understand from the author, that it is a spiritual discovery from the guru to Shishya. And when I was asked to preside over this event, you know, I wondered if I was up to the task because I feel very dwarfed and humbled in the presence of such spiritual greatness and the august gathering here. So my heartfelt gratitude to Narayan Ashrama Tapovanam and the Center for Inner Resources Development for this opportunity to play my small part in this great spiritual undertaking that you have endeavored on. You know, ours is a very blessed land that many spiritual masters have set foot here, and to make their thoughts, their teachings accessible to generations to come is a very onerous and a very, responsible, important task. But when this task is undertaken by someone who has experienced the master's spiritual teachings firsthand, you know, concurrent during their lifetime, I think it becomes even more special, because often we hear or read about the great teachers who lived centuries ago. But it is very rare that during one's lifetime, the teachings and the life experiences of a master are captured beautifully in a book. I think that's what makes your effort of the Great Association, a very unique effort. I think the Guru-Shishya relationship is a very unique relationship, you know, innate to our culture and our tradition. I think it goes beyond the transactional and, you know, material aspects of teaching and learning that we commonly see in academic institutes. I think this relationship is more profound, something more deeper to it. It takes a great teacher, a very devoted student, to bring out the best and the finest of this tradition in teaching, learning, and experiencing. So I'm glad to see that, you know, this book is such a fine exposition of that Guru-Shishya parampara that our land has been blessed with. One is often fortunate to have the blessings of directly learning from the Guru, as you have, sir, but it does not necessarily happen in every situation and context in life. Earlier, when I was sitting there with Swamiji, he asked me how things were at Prasar Bharati. And I said that, you know, it's quite challenging, you know, we've not progressed as fast as we could have. And he was inquiring why, and I said, you know, there's so many challenges, both internal and external. And more importantly, there were few lessons from my private sector life that prepared me for that challenge. Because working in the private sector, you know, things are different. Things are organized, structured in a certain way. Once you come to the public sector, the complexities are very different. And when I used to think about those challenges a year back, I remember that I would look to Sridharanji's experience and you know, what challenges that he must have faced while building out the metro infrastructure in the country. And so I managed to lay my hands on one of the biographies. I don't know if it was an authorized biography, but it was one of the biographies on Sridharanji. And I would read chapters from that on my flights to learn more about, you know, how he went about this challenging task in his experience. So in that sense, he became my guru, though I couldn't learn directly from him. Whatever little I could read was, you know, from what I could gather from the books that I laid my hands on. So I feel very blessed that he's here today, and the book release happened in his august presence. I think Sridharanji has demonstrated what the best of India can produce, what the best of India can create, on par with the rest of the world. And it would be my endeavor to, you know, apply the learnings that I could, you know, glean to the world of public broadcasting, aspire to, you know, reach that high benchmark that he has set. So hopefully, you know, one day Prasar Bharati is also spoken about in a similar manner that Delhi Metro is, you know, spoken about. Very good. So, you know, while you have, you know, given the title A Great Association, I think this was a cosmic association that, you know, it brought me here today, you know, to receive the blessings from Sridharanji. So thank you again for that. My sincere gratitude to Swamiji and Ashok, who was instrumental in, you know, making this happen, and where I could offer the first copy of the book to Sridharanji, who will be a role model for the years to come for me. It makes this occasion doubly blessed, as I also became aware of this unique master-disciple relationship, and I also got the opportunity to see the blessings of the master himself. I've strongly believed, in fact, in the introduction, you know, very kindly, you spoke about, you know, my work in the digital space, and I've always believed that it's very important that our spiritual knowledge, our, you know, culture, our history has to be digitally preserved for the generations to come, to make it accessible, you know, not just to people across India, but to, you know, people across the world in multiple languages. And so my hope is that even the Great Association will have a strong digital presence in multiple languages, so that disciples from across the world are able to access the learnings from it. My best wishes to the Narayana Ashrama Tapovanam and the Center for Inner Resources Development. My salutations again to Pooja Swamiji. May the light of knowledge guide us all. Namaste.
Thank you, Shashiji. We would request Sridharanji to please address everyone.
Before I start, I wish to offer my most respectful pranams at the holy feet of Swami Bhumananda Tirtha Ji. I offer my pranams to Swami Nirveshwaranand Ji and Ma Guru Priya Ji. My greetings to Sri Shashi Shekhar Vempati and all the distinguished guests and devotees present here. I consider it as a great blessing to be present today here on this occasion when the pictorial handbook, A Great Association, authored by Swami Nirveshwaranandi, is being launched. As Brahmacharini Namaraji pointed out, all devotees of Swamiji have been eagerly waiting for the launching of this book. And I feel particularly fortunate to be the person to receive this first copy of the book on this occasion, and that too from an eminent person like Sri Vempati himself. This book is a compilation of various stages of Swamiji's spiritual life, his early life, his Purvashrama days, the way he came up from that small little village, Paralikkad, and became an enlightened person, a Mahatma by himself, and has been guiding and inspiring large number of devotees in India and abroad as well. Narayana Satamovanam has brought out very many publications in English, in Malayalam, and in Hindi as well. But this is the first time a pictorial handbook of this type, what we generally refer to as a coffee table book, is being brought out. The author, Swami Nirveshwaranandi Ji, has taken a lot of pains to collect various known and unknown aspects of Swamiji's life, bring them together in this book with appropriate photographs juxtapositioned, and also the very appropriate descriptions of Swamiji's life, etc. The book also contains, almost on every page, some very valuable quotation, spiritual quotation of Swami Brahmananda Tirthaji. Quotations which I consider are really spiritual pearls placed before us. I had the good fortune to go through this book before it was finally ready for the final printing. And I was really impressed and amazed to see how all aspects of Swamiji's life, work, is particularly his vision and his efforts in spreading Brahma Vidya to various corners of the world, all has been brought out so succinctly and so beautifully. I had always wondered what prompted Swami Nirvishesananda Ji to author this book, to author a book of this type. Is it just his Guru Bhakti? Or is it only an effort to record or to bring together all his emotions, his feelings, and his experiences? While living with Swamiji for the last 31 years in the ashram, living with him, working with him, eating with him, and involved in all his activities throughout, is it only that? I think there is something more than that, what prompted him to write this book. I feel it is nothing but the eloquent response to the high traditions of Guru Shishya Parampara. How the sacred knowledge, the truth, have been handed over to us from days, from years, millions of years ago, how it has been handed over from Guru to Shishya, and that Shishya became a Guru, again to another Shishya, and it has come to us today, this knowledge. I think this book is an outcome of this fundamental principle of Guru Shishya Parampara, I feel. The author of the book has correctly pointed out that this book is not a biographical account of Swamiji's life, an effort which will need a huge volume to be written, if that is to be covered. He has called it a spiritual sadhana. In fact, the book is an outcome of the spiritual sadhana of the author, Swami Nirvishesananda himself, I feel. It is the outcome of his sadhana. And Swamiji himself, in the introduction to the book, "To know is to become," has so beautifully portrayed the essential relevance and essence of this book to the devotees. I'm not going into the details of that, but that introduction itself shows what is the relevance of this book and how it will affect the lives of the devotees and seekers. These have been brought out here.